You are good and you are my saint forever. Please celebrate Jesus. Please put your hands together. Please put your hands together for the truth. All right, distinguished ladies. Okay, I beg your pardon. All right, thank you very much for that. I'm from the eastern part. Okay. So today we are going to be doing more of hair. We are going to be learning it together. So we are doing this together. So our mommies and daddy, the sweet ladies and gentlemen, please. Put your hands together for yourself once more. Our daddies, our mommies, beautifully dressed for these occasions. I celebrate every one of us. I celebrate each and every one of us. We are going to be waiting for the celebrant to come out for the dance. So before the celebrant will be coming out for the dance, I don't know if there's
a privilege and opportunity given to our Papa, Pa Emmanuel Olayinka Oyeyemi, to see this beautiful day. Father, we thank you for good health that you have rendered unto him. Be exalted in the name of Jesus. Amen. Those who you are going to use for this program, empower them. Amen. Feed them. Amen. So that at the end of everything, Lord, we will look back and say, thank you, Father. Lord, those who are coming on their way to this program, be with them. Amen. Let them meet us in peace. Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I pray for Papa. I pray for Mama. I pray for the children. I pray for those who are here, even the family. Father, pray for us. Amen. Be with us. Amen. From the beginning to the end, take glory. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Celebration of life. Are you ready now? It's time.
floor. Put your hands together for Daddy. Daddy, we did try. In fact, the way that he was going down, was going down, I was like, Daddy, I don't know. All right. Ready? Pastor Oladeyinde. Please put your hands together for our Daddy, the man of God, the anointed one that has come here to bless us. Please put your hands together for the anointed. God bless you, sir. You are highly welcome, sir.
The word of God reads thus: to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die.
In this sense, I'm not busy. God bless you. Thank you very much, sir, for that Bible reading. And also to proceed to the word of exhortation, I would like us to invite to the microphone our dear pastor. Please, ladies and gentlemen, this phone in person of Pastor Akiyemi. Please put your hands together for our daddy. God bless you, sir.
Praise the living Jesus. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I want to sincerely greet God, Baba, name of Jesus, to Mama, everybody. I extend my greetings to the children, like your doctor, every other member of the house, and the children, and the grandchildren. All right. Àwọn èèyàn ti ń sun òyìnbó gan-an tó ti pọ̀, aṣọ méjèèjì, àtòyìnbó àti Yorùbá. Èyí tó bá ti bá níbẹ̀, ó ti jáde, òun náà ló jáde. Our everlasting Father, we thank you for this wonderful hour. Receive our thanks, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Daddy, we thank you for the grace of 88th birthday of our Father, Pa Oyeyemi. We pray, Father, that you grant him more peace, more healthy life, in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray that the children will be in peace, the wife will be in peace, the grandchildren will be in peace, the whole family will be in peace, in the mighty name of Jesus. As we go into your word, Father, we pray, speak to our heart in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I'm fearfully and wonderfully made.
Marvelous are thy words.
Marvelous are thy words.
And that my soul knoweth right well.
Yes, praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
What does the Bible say there? The Bible says we are wonderfully made. We are specially made. So it is not an accident that I'm created into this world. It is not an accident that 80 years ago, Baba was created into this world. To occupy a space, to do something, to bring something to the light, and to come to the limelight of this world. Every space in time and in life is meaningful. The space that you can occupy is limited. God has given it limitation. That every individual, you are going to spend so number of years on earth. That's the space you are going to occupy in life. Please, I'm imploring you. Please use it judiciously. Use it to serve your Creator.
And thou shalt call his name Jesus.
Yes.
For he shall save his people from their sins.
Yes.
Now all this was done. Mm-hmm. That it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord.
Uh-huh.
By the prophet saying, mm-hmm. Behold, a virgin shall be with child,
mm-hmm.
and shall bring forth a son.
Uh-huh.
And they shall call his name Emmanuel.
Yes.
Which be interpreted is God with us.
Thank you. God bless you. Now we can see from the Bible that by the time Jesus was coming, God gave him what is going to fulfill on earth. One of the fulfillment of Christ is that he must come to save his people from sin. The second one is that Jesus must come to this world to deliver us, not Lord and Savior, so that you'll be able to fulfill your destiny on the earth's surface. I pray once again, you will fulfill it in Jesus' name. Lastly, number five, time and season is given so that you can apply your heart unto the wisdom of God. Time and season is given to you so that you can apply your heart to the wisdom of God. Can somebody read Psalm 90 verse 12? Psalm 90 verse 12. Time and season are given so that you can apply your heart to wisdom.
Our heart unto wisdom.
That we may apply our heart to wisdom. Praise the living Jesus. Galatians, and to everyone that is here, my emphasis here today is that your being on heart is on purpose. You are not here on earth accidentally. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this hour. Receive our thanks in Jesus' name. We have given exposition that we can give on your word. I pray, Holy Spirit, take preeminent control of every individual's heart and liberate us from power of sin. This Christmas time, the purpose of Jesus on earth is to save us from our sins. I pray you will save us from our sins in Jesus' name. And the word we have listened to will not stand against us in the day of judgment. Thank you because you've answered our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord.
You better. Thank you very much, sir. Very invite. And also we have in our midst the chairman. Okay, we have the chairman. Well, welcome our daddy. You're welcome, sir. You're welcome. God bless you. Thank you very much. We have the Hillview Estate neighbors and friends. Please put your hands together yourself. You're all welcome. And also, we still have more people joining us this afternoon. We'll be doing the introduction gradually, gradually.
20,000 there. Please put your hands together, my daddy. And now, daddy, it's still me. Daddy, today we are in Abeokuta City. Okiata, to be very precise, very good. Now, daddy, it's me. Daddy, that thing you used to do before that you did in Abuja, you did it last month. Daddy, don't forget me. That thing, I just said, let me remind you, won't take it or anything, man. Sir. So, Emak Bagbemi, sir. About this shit, sir. About it. Check. You can never forget. Please put your hands together with my daddy. Daddy said you can never forget.
The blessed memory of our mommy, may our soul continue to rest in perfect peace in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Please, let's go seated.
Dear Eternal Father, we are really very grateful to you for that which you have done for our Father. Pa Emmanuel, Ola Yemeka, Oyeyemi. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for sustaining him. Thank you for upholding him. Thank you for giving him good health all the time. Father, be glorified in the name of Jesus. Today, the children are celebrating our Father. Lord, I pray, as they are celebrating him, we pray he will never mourn over any of them in the name of Jesus. Baba Oyeyemi, today we are celebrating you. Evil will never prevail. Baba Odo Alelewa, Odo Due Yeni Awoma Yije Ene Kenini No Wakone Redano. Owo aye ko ni kan won, ina aye ko ni jo won, ewu aye ko ni wu won, irin ajo aye won ko ni dojuru, ona ayo won ko ni dopin. Eyin na pelu baba lojo ale yi itura atoke wa yo je ipe yin lekan si ilera to peye yo je ti yin on to pa yin lere ko ni pa yin leku iti baje ko ni wo oro yin mama pelu ti won je aya fun yin owo olorun yo dara si won alati leyin ni won je itibaje o ni wo oro won iwa laaye olorun
yo laye won se rere won se ogorin odun fun yin loni nigbati adorun odun okun e wa laaye e wa ni ilera to peye iwa laaye olorun yo pe awon na ro ewu ise ko le mu mo opo olorun yo pa aye wa orukọ Jesu Kristi.
Celebrate Jesus, celebrate Jesus. Thank you very much for that wonderful, wonderful heartfelt prayer.
So ladies and gentlemen, my name is, as you all know, my name is Xleo, the man with mobility, originality, the man with school credibility, and also born in my locality, and I have an account of fidelity. Please be challenging enough for the MC now. I'll try. Now, Mr. Lewis, we say a true. Now, if the one that not pay me most, the one that pay me most in this greeting, just last week, robbers came to my neighbor's house to rob.
Man of the Ascension, we especially welcome you, sir. Baba the King Adeleye, we especially welcome you, sir. The Bagura pastor and the pastorate, the team from Bagura Baptist Church, we thank you, we appreciate you for honoring our invitation. And every other person that is physical, ever, and we have mercy. And now we have compassion on whoever we have compassion. So then it is not of him.
And it's sorry, because it's a lot of tissue.
We are here, we are gathered here to see the life of mercy and favor in the life of this man you are sitting here. What we are doing here is celebrating God, appreciating God for his mercy and favor. If you want to know what is favor, or you want to hear what is favor or mercy, yes, I'm telling you, this is an example of a life of David. If you try some of the things he has done, you might have been consumed. But because God has decided to have mercy and grace, that is why we are here. Again, there's a lady in the Bible, Emma Rahab. Rahab, no, highly disciplinarian. If I say disciplinarian, very tough. Very, very tough. How I got to know my dad was, King one man called me in 123 ABC. Oh, they make me see last one. Belu ekbani. ABC. Oh, so be wire. Wire. Wire at the horse whip. It was very, very tough. At the time, some of us said, "Why did we even come to this house? Because if my father come, the house become tense. There's tension everywhere. Everybody will not
come in from." But somehow, when his mother came into the city, she said, "Are you this man? You must be blind. For you to say this boy is not your son. Can't you see this is a carbon copy of my twin brother?" Well, that's the way it started. But along the line, just like what my elder brother said, we used to think he was a wicked man. I was just unnecessarily wicked to us because he's a really, really strict disciplinarian. I can't take this. But you know, as a man, being who a man is, he cannot reveal his weakness to his children. He wants to remain a strong man that his children will look up to. So maybe out of Oboju, no, and you don't need this. But one thing, credit I want to give to him is that he never faltered when it comes to education. Papa, can you remember? Sometime he can, because I believe as his wife,
till about 6. He did kabu kabu. As an insurance man, when he gets back from work by 5:30, he said, Femi, Larry, I'm coming. He'll take his car and go and do kabu kabu. I'm talking of the 80. So that is the kind of father we have. Yeah, we really didn't appreciate it much then, but now that we are adults, we give all the glory and we appreciate him for his sacrifice towards us. I used to tell my children, sometimes they'll say, Daddy, you are a little bit difficult. I say, you know what? Look at the story of my family. All of us, we were all successful in our chosen field. That if being difficult is what will make me achieve the kind of success that my dad achieved, then I want to be difficult and strict with you children. So I want everybody to appreciate and thank God for the kind of daddy he gave us. That's why we thought it wise to just gather together and celebrate and appreciate him before he takes his final exit from here. Praise the Lord. Daddy, I say thank you so much. We appreciate it. And may God continue to give you strength, good health, until you are called upon yonder. Praise the Lord.
But I'd like to tell you just two short stories about my own personal life and my experience with my dad. First, I would like to tell you about when I was about to get into medical school. I was thinking, how was I going to get into medical school? To cut the long story short, I got an admission into OSU, Ogun State University, to study medicine. When we got to OSU, they gave us the bill. We were to pay 10,000 naira or so for school fees. I went to meet my dad and I showed him. He was so happy. You can just imagine how happy he was. But at that point, he had just retired. We had lost our mother. He looked at it and said, you have to study this medicine, but how are we going to pay these school fees? He didn't have any money coming in. I'm sure he probably will not remember now, but I remember telling you, I was grown already. We were not thinking, how will we pay these school fees? Well, that's one very important story in my life. Eventually, I didn't go to that school. I got to the University of Ilorin, where my school fees was 400 and something. All through medical school, you have to pay for the expensive books, all sorts of things, school fees and all of that. The last story I want to tell you about was when I was now finishing. I called him, I said, Daddy, I've graduated, I'm now a medical doctor. He was so happy, rolled on the floor. I wasn't there, but he was just so happy. Then he told me something. He said, does this mean after paying this money, I'm not going to pay any money again? I said, yes, sir. The money I was supposed to pay, the other money that I accrued was about 20,000 plus or so. Do you know what my dad did? Instead of paying 20,000, he sent me 35,000. I was so happy, and I want to thank you. For me, it's so critical in the sense that, why it's so critical for me is that, when I remember when we lost our mom, just imagine somebody that was in GS3 then, and I had to live alone, stay alone, because you know, the family was divided into like two or three. So much in me and in education that he said, do I want to remain in Kaduna? Because I started my education, I was in GS3. And I dreaded leaving my secondary school. And he said, okay, if you want to stay, I will allow you to stay. We call him impregnable Oyus. He cannot be defeated in anything. That's what we call him. Something in the Bible, they say, see a man that is diligent in his work, he will stand before him. When it comes to being diligent, anything he handles, is it discipline? He's diligent in it. He will discipline you. He's not in a hurry to discipline you, so that you will take that, it will sink into you. But now, we can see that the Lord has helped you, and you are even done beyond what we thought you would do. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you very much, Eshegun. Along with them, I'll check you. I'm up to Ashman, along with my mouth. You know, you can check what they did, so you can see it.
Thank you very much, Mr. DJ. Now we have Dear Toromi Ogeyemi, on behalf of all the grandchildren, is going to be having a poem rendition. Please, a round of applause for our dear. Put your hands together, hey, young man. Put your hands together for this young man. God bless you.
Number one, grandpa follows protocols. He does not sit his behind. Number two, he hates deception. Number three, he hates misbehaviors. And for all these reasons, I love Grandpa because of one special reason. You get to know. He gave back to my father, and he also gave back to my other uncles and aunts. Thank you. And on behalf of all the grandchildren, I am telling Grandpa, happy birthday.
You can show a man the good side, the bad side, and the ugly side. And this is what my speech will be based on. First, on his good side, I'll be looking, okay, first, I am an educationist. And as an educationist, my testimony about my daddy will be, first, I'll be attaching him to three philosophers, who are Aristotle, Plato, and Aristophanes. Now, one great philosophy about Plato is, he said, I love what God wants. Now, why I say this, as an educationist, one thing you've come to realize that, as a father, as a parent, you should not dictate what you think it is right. Always give room to your children to express, okay, this is what I think, this is what the way I view it, and agree with them. He is a mechanical man when it comes to his actions. This is the way I want it, and nothing more. Now, another thing, one of his philosophy, he used the philosophy of divide and rule. Yeah, many of you may not understand when I say divide and rule. Now, he has this thing that, okay, he wants to be at the center of it all. Now, and you know, police have this thing that, okay, for them to win, to have everybody under their care, they want you not to believe in the other man, and then the other man not believing in you. He has that belief that, okay, I am the best for you all. No other person can treat you better than me. But in life, you cannot always be the best. And then another thing,
I appreciate our daddy, please put your hands together as our daddy comes onto the screen to watch the presentations from the video slides.
proceeding to the cutting on the cake.
believe we all are enjoying the moment. I believe we all are enjoying ourselves. Sit back, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Our dear mommies and daddies, friends and well wishers from the estate. It's a very big thank you. As you enjoy yourself, while we proceed to the next program of the day. Congratulations, daddy. Many, many happy returns. I pray that this year and many, many more to celebrate in good health, long life and prosperity for you and your family, the family of Oguyemi. So shortly, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to proceed in to the cutting of cake and also the order of photographs with the celebrant of the day. So while we enjoy music and also enjoy our food and our drinks. God bless you.
I'm gonna go. I'm Oh yeah, give me the teacher.
has been there too. He is your God. You want to come to
Show me the dance.
those from Lagos, Kaduna, Ibadan, wherever you have come from. We thank, we appreciate you, and we pray that God is going to grant you joy in Mercy Platform. Especially, I want to appreciate the family of my beloved late mother, Mrs. Jones, Funky Alaja, Resikat, Antitoyi, and Lati, and every other person represented my mom's family. And to mommy too that came, we say thank you so much. We appreciate your contribution and support. May God replenish wherever that those tokens came from. And as we all be going back home, God will take our home safely. We thank you once again, and we pray that every soul present here will live to live beyond 80 years in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We thank you, we appreciate you. This is time for dance, dance, dance. Anybody, we're going to be playing music, we're going to be dancing with the celebrant. If you want to celebrate, please come forward and do the same. Thank you so much.
Bye.
My ears have heard, waited for.